Pretty much, just about whatever you want. Some people like the corn on it.
Jalapenos?
Jalapenos, thank you. You can also put some honey over the top of it.
Onions?
Onions. Go ahead, cameraman, help me out here.
Sorry.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine. Bubba likes all the help he can get. You want to make sure it's mixed up pretty good. Now, before I went ahead and started this, I put about 3 tablespoons of Earl into my pan and put it in the oven. Go ahead and get it to where it'll thin out, so we can go ahead and make sure it coats the bottom of the pan real, real good. Yeah, that's good. Right now, I'm going to put it up here. Next, whoop, I'm grinding my onions up over here. Move them chuckers out of the way. Now I'm going to put the pan down. Listen, that shizzle. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and pour my cornbread mix. Now this one right here is white cornbread. Usually I use the yellow cornbread, but I didn't go out and buy this batch. Mrs. Cam did. Get all that out. Now something that I like to do, once I get something on to grab the pan with, because that thing's darn hot. Heard it sizzle. Okay, now I go ahead and just kind of pat it down. Try and get as much of the air out as possible. That's great to do for your cakes, too. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and put this in the oven. I got the oven set to 425. There we go. And then that's getting ready to cook. Well, I got my onions chopped for my fried taters. Now I need to go ahead and peel my taters. And then just as soon as I get them all ready up, I'll go ahead and come back to you and show you the next step. Okay, now we're back, and we got the cornbread done, and I'll show you that here after a while. And then what we're going to do now is we're going to start fried taters. So we're going to get us some shortening. Now, if you're health conscious,
come on, baby, do it. Come on.
I'm working on it.
Don't give it, baby. Come on.
Now I use a lot of it. Now, not many people use a lot of nothing.
You use a little bit, baby. You don't know what you're talking about.
Anyway, you got to use enough so that your taters won't stick, because they have a tendency to stick, and you don't want that. So now what we're going to do is go ahead and heat up the pan with our Earl in it, and then we're going to add our taters, which we've already chopped up right over here. And we got our onions. Now I've chopped up a whole onion, but you don't have to use a whole onion. You can only use half of it or a quarter. Just really depends on you.
Yeah.
But anyway, we'll check back with you when the Earl's ready to put the taters in. Okay, anyway, now we're gonna go ahead and add in our taters and our onions to the hot oil. I'm hoping this ain't gonna bite me. The cameraman is really hoping it. It bit me. I knew it was going to bite me. Cameraman, you are in for it.
Cool.
Okay. Now we're getting our potatoes in there. Now that we got our taters in there, we're going to go ahead and salt and pepper it. I hope they're talking. Okay, I see it. Your pepper. That ain't enough. I need real pepper. I like lots of pepper. Oh, I wish you could all smell this at home, but boy, it smells good. Nothing like the smell of fried taters. That is pepper, right? Okay, that is pepper. Lord knows I don't want to put no parsley in it or what have you. Okay, close this thing up. Put it back on the shelf. where I found it. Well, okay, well, not quite where I found it, but, you know, somewhere in there. Okay, now I gotta look for me something to start with. You know, Bubba should have been prepared for all this, but things just did not work out the way I wanted them to. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and work them all around. Oh man, if you can smell this at home, y'all be ready for some eating, some good old eating. I'll turn this heat down just a little bit. Oh, these are gonna be good. Okay. Now, if you got a cast iron skillet, I find that's the best thing for it. So you just, there's something about the cast iron that really brings out the flavor. Now, some of y'all may doubt that, but you try it. You go ahead and get you a regular one and get you cast iron and tell me if you don't notice a difference. Okay, now what I want to do is I want to go ahead and cover this up and let it sit there and cook a while. And then when it gets good and done, I'll come back and show you. Okay, our food is all prepared. Now, when it comes to beans, you can add more than just beans. And you could, instead of using this kind of meat, you could use squirrel. That's, you know, pretty much squirrels everywhere, I think. But anyway, I like to go ahead and fix me up some nice beans, put it on the plate. Really, I like to use bowls, but, you know, we're doing this mainly for the look, so, you know, we want to look all pretty for you. Oh, don't them beans look good? Oh, them beans look good. Little pork on there. Then we'll get us some taters. You've got to have you some taters. Oh, y'all could just smell it. Oh, that looks good. Then, we're going to get us some cornbread. Oh, ain't that pretty. Oh, that's some good-looking cornbread right there. Get you a nice fork. Stir that little baby up. And that's some good eating right there. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed it. I don't know where Grandma got off to, but, she's probably out there taking a nap, because, you know, Grandma gets tired. But anyway, I'll talk with y'all later. Bye.